All right, today we're going through a carburetor on a 1987 Kawasaki KX250 dirt bike. This is a two-stroke motorcycle. I've showed you how to remove this carburetor off of the motorcycle. Make sure you check that video out in the link below. Also going to give a couple links for a couple of special tools that I use, as well as the carb kit to rebuild these, as well as some of the other products that I use during this video. Like I said, we've got the carburetor off. I've showed you how to remove this carburetor from the motorcycle. Typically, what I would do is this top cap here, as well as the slide and the spring, would stay on the cable. A lot of times that would stay on the motorcycle. You don't typically have an issue with the slide, the needle, or the cap, but I just wanted to show you what the entire carburetor looks like off of the motorcycle. So we're gonna spin that cap off, going back together. You wanna make sure that you get these threads lined up and screwed in the correct position there. That way you aren't cross-threading those. They are a very fine threaded cap there, easy to cross-thread. You also, in this cap here, you've got a rubber seal. Make sure that that's good before you go back together. We've got our spring here, and then we've got our slide along with our needle that sits down in here. So setting the carburetor aside there, we've got our needle here, and I can show you how to replace that. Down in this slide here, we've got a portion of this that will come out of there when you tip it upside down. This piece here holds that throttle cable in our groove there. In our groove that's right there, this slide here will hold it in. That spring will sit down right on top of there, so that'll hold this holder in place, and those kind of work together there. Our needle here, you won't be able to push out there until you undo these two Phillips screws that are down in our slide. So removing those. Okay, once we remove those Phillips screws there, you can take and pull up on this this needle holder here. We're gonna set that down. Now we can take and push our needle up out of that groove there. This is an adjustable needle. You've got, looks like five different settings here on this needle. They also make different sizes of needles, and those sizes are engraved right there on the needle. Make sure and check that out. Get the right one for your motorcycle and for your riding conditions. Going back together then, slide that needle in. Then we'll take this holder here, slide that down. Doesn't matter which direction that goes. We'll tighten up these Phillips screws here. All right, snug these up. Now our needle's not gonna be able to pop out of there. I should have showed you when I had this holder off of there, but our throttle cable will slide up through that groove there. So it's got a wider opening at the bottom there. Take and slide that cable up, and it'll actually hook in position there where my screwdriver is. And then to pull it out of there, just push it down and slide it out and then pull it out. That's how you remove that cable. I think I've gone over that in my other carb removal video. So setting these parts aside, I'm gonna go down into the bowl of the carburetor next. Take and flip that carburetor up. You can remove this cap there. That'll allow you to drain that fuel from the bottom of your carburetor. Also will allow you to swap out your main jet. If you take and add an exhaust pipe to your motorcycle there, there's really no reason to pull this entire bowl off. If you add an aftermarket exhaust, you can just pull this cap here, replace your main jet to what they would suggest using, and put this cap back on. The other nice thing is, if you have dirt and debris sitting in the bottom of this bowl here, that dirt and debris is gonna end up in this cap here. So you can remove that cap, clean out the dirt and debris. The problem is, if your motorcycle isn't running good, most of the time you've got to actually clean those jets out. Clean your main jet and your pilot jet. You also want to make sure, if your motorcycle is leaking fuel on your floor, that you do want to make sure that your float is set in the correct position there. So I suggest most of the time pulling this carburetor off, pulling this bowl, inspecting this, replacing anything that needs replaced there. Got four Phillips screws that we're going to remove around the outside of this bowl here. Remove our Phillips screws here. Once we get those completely out of there, we can take and remove this bowl. You see, you've got a bottom nipple here on this bowl. That is your overflow tube. So this brass tube that's up here is your overflow. It's gonna run down, it's gonna run out this bottom nipple here. You should have a hose connect to here, and that's gonna run down below your motor there. If this nipple here does not have a fuel hose connected to it, that fuel is just gonna drop directly onto your motor. You're gonna discolor your motor there. Could potentially start a fire. So make sure you check that out. Make sure you've got a bottom vent hose hooked up here. Make sure that that vent hose isn't plugged. If this line is plugged here, that fuel will overflow into this bottom bowl here, and then it's gonna dump into your motor. So you wanna make sure that This tube is cleaned out, so you're not having that issue. There's this bottom cap that I was talking about that you can remove. Dirt and debris can stay down in this area here, but a lot of times, since this is the lowest position, if you take and pull this, a lot of that dirt and debris is just gonna drop out that bottom hole there. Now, that being said, I would strongly suggest you pulling this bowl if your bike isn't running right or you feel like you need a carb clean. Pull this bowl, that way you can inspect everything here. Setting that aside, I'm gonna go now to our float assembly, which is this here. Fuel runs into your carburetor from your fuel tank. And this inlet here, it's gonna run down a rail that's inside your carburetor. It's gonna come and run out this bottom needle valve here. So when that fuel, when that float is down, it's gonna allow fuel to run into your bottom bowl area. As that float rises, your fuel line is gonna raise. It's gonna shut this bottom fuel valve off. This needle and seat here is gonna shut that fuel off. No more fuel will be allowed to run into your bottom bowl area. As that fuel drops again, it's going to drop this float, and that needle and seat there is gonna open up, allowing more fuel to soak in. So back and forth, same thing. This goes up and down a lot of times while you're riding that motorcycle. A lot of times when you're riding, it's gonna stay in the open position. If you're sitting there coming to an idle, it's gonna raise up, it's gonna fill that bottom bowl up because you're not using as much fuel. To remove this float and our needle valve there, you can take a pick or a small screwdriver and push on this tab here. It's gonna push out one direction, which is this. What you do wanna make sure that you don't take a pick and a hammer and slam on these tabs here. These are aluminum tabs. They have a tendency to break. They break very, very easily. When you do break them, there is no fixing them. You just have to replace your carburetor. So pull that pin out very carefully, set that aside. Now we've got our float that comes out. This is an adjustable float here. You've got this tab that you can raise or lower depending on what you need. Check your manual for those specifications on your float height. They typically read those in inches or millimeters, and it'll tell you how to adjust those floats. I've got separate videos on how to adjust those floats if your manual doesn't show you that. Now to replace your needle here, you can take this clip, push this out, and don't let that go flying across the room if you're planning on reusing it. And I would suggest keeping it because most jet kits don't come with this clip there. So you're just gonna slide that out. Now you're able to take and pull that needle out of there. Inspect that, make sure there's no grooving, make sure there's no wear. Blow through this port here with compressed air and carbon choke cleaner. Make sure there's nothing down in that bottom end there. Take a 9mm wrench there and set it on top of that seat there, and you can take and remove that. Before I do that, I'm gonna remove up here so you can see a little bit better. So we've got our main jet that's sitting up here. This is gonna be a 6mm wrench if you're gonna remove this main jet. Loosen that up, we can pull that main jet out. Now you wanna make sure that you inspect this, make sure you can see through there, make sure you can blow through there with carbon choke cleaner. If you cannot see through that main jet or blow through with carbon choke cleaner, I would suggest grabbing a jet cleaner tool here. Take and find the right size, and then you can take and clean this out. It's got ribbed ends on there, so you can clean out any kind of dirt or debris that's stuck to the side of that jet. You're gonna be able to clean out. Should be able to blow through that with carbon choke cleaner and not have any issues. We've got a plastic spacer on here. We also have a brass spacer there that you can take and push out. A lot of times, because these are such big orifices, you're not gonna have the issue of these getting dirty and filled up with dirt and debris. But if there is dirt or debris stuck on here, make sure you clean that out. And then we've got our pilot jet down in here. If your motorcycle is having a hard time starting or idling, more than likely it's gonna be your pilot jet. So grab a small screwdriver, stick that down there, make sure it's seated properly, and then take and unscrew that. When you've got that loosened up, you can tip that over, dump it out. There's your pilot jet there, it looks like that. There's also gonna be sizes engraved on this jet, so you wanna make sure that you inspect that. Make sure you've got the right size jet in there. Now, what a lot of people will comment and ask me, if they've got a motorcycle that just isn't starting, do they need to replace your pilot jet or do you need to change sizes? If your motorcycle used to idle just fine or used to rev up just fine, and then it sat through the winter, sat for a couple months, and now it won't rev up or it won't idle just fine, you don't need to replace or change sizes on anything. You just need to clean these jets out. Now, if you can't see through these at all when you're holding up to light, then I would suggest replacing them. But 9 times out of 10, You can clean these and your bike will idle and run just fine again. You can also take carbon choke cleaner, blow through these ports here to make sure all those passageways are cleaned out. Now to remove our seat here for our needle in our seat, you take and pull that. You can inspect that. There's a size on this as well engraved in the bottom. Make sure you've got the right size there. You've got a small washer here, and that's a sealed washer, and that's supposed to keep that fuel from leaking out. Underneath of there, you've got the same thing, a sealed washer on the bottom. Make sure that those both are in good condition before you go back together. A lot of times a jet kit won't include those two spacers there. Slide that back down. Again, this whole time you can take carbon choke cleaner, blow through there, take compressed air and blow through there. Take a 9mm wrench, snug that up, and take our needle valve there, drop it down in there. Now we can take our clip, very carefully slide that in position. Then we can take, and we can put our float on now. Again, making sure all these pieces are cleaned up and have no dirt or debris stuck to them. Slide this into place there. You can see there's grooves cut on the top side there. You can slide that brass fitting into place. Doesn't really matter how far you slide that in, as long as it stays on there. It can't slide too far down. It can't slide, well, I guess it could slide too far up, but won't slide too far down. You can slide it all the way down. You just wanna make sure that that is secure on there. Take our main jet, put that back on, making sure you can see through there with carbon choke cleaner. Tighten that up with our 6mm. Take our pilot jet, drop it down in there. Make sure that you've got a good hold on here before you start twisting this pilot jet, because I don't want you to round this jet off of there. Take, attach that. Now we've got our float here and our pin that's gonna slide all the way through. If you can't get that on and slid all the way through, inspect it really good. Make sure there's nothing that you're catching on. And now we can take and put our bowl on. Before I do that, I wanna show you this quick. When you have got a needle on here, and we're gonna slide this needle down. Now, if you're gonna give your motorcycle throttle, slide is down in there. I don't know which direction to show. I'm gonna show you this direction. I'm gonna explain a little bit of how a carburetor works. Say our throttle cable's hooked up. We've got our spring here and our cap on. Throttle cable's hooked up. I twist the throttle at the handlebars. That's gonna take and raise this slide up. At the same time, that's gonna allow fuel to come up through your main jet, come up. Air is flowing this direction, so down in this video, and into your motor. The farther that we twist that throttle, the farther our slide and our needle are gonna raise, the more fuel that is allowed to come up and dump into your motor, the more air that's allowed to come up through this venturi here. Now, if we were to take and put a larger main jet, when we've got full throttle or even partially open throttle, that's gonna allow more fuel to come up and be sucked up through our main jet here and go up into our motor there. Same thing, if we put a smaller main jet in there, less fuel that's being dumped into our motor when this slide is starting to raise. Our pilot jet, which is back here, there's a small orifice on the back side of this carburetor, this right here, that sucks that fuel up through there when you're sitting there idling. So if our motorcycle is completely closed there, almost completely closed, gonna be very little amount of air sucked through this carburetor, and this pilot jet is still gonna be allowed to run that fuel up through that orifice there, through the pilot jet, through that orifice there, and dump into our motor. So that's why it's essential, because at this point here, our main jet is completely closed because this needle is all the way down. That's why when your motorcycle is not idling properly, your pilot jet is gonna be the issue almost every time. The other issue that you might have is your choke here. This is your choke plunger. I'll show you how to get to that here in a second, but we've got an orifice here where air is going to filter through. It's going to come through your choke area here, and I'll show you that in a little bit. And that's gonna allow fuel to get sucked up through your pilot jet area even quicker yet. There's only gonna be so much fuel and air that's gonna be allowed through here, but because that choke is on, that's gonna continue to let air flow through your choke assembly area here. So that's kind of the general basics to how a carburetor works. If you guys have questions, make sure you leave those in the comments below. But almost every carburetor that has a system like this is gonna function that exact same way. Twist that throttle, slide goes up, needle goes up, allows more fuel through that main jet and down into your motor. Slide goes down, that shuts the fuel off, and air is very slowly getting sucked through these ports here, sucking fuel up through your pilot jet there, allowing your motorcycle to idle. So not very much fuel, not very much air, but enough to keep that motorcycle idling. Now when you go to adjust your idle on your motorcycle, you turn this up, and I would suggest doing small increments on this. You turn this up, that's actually gonna take and raise your slide slightly, and then gonna allow more fuel to flow through there, sucking more fuel up through your jets there. So turn that idle down, it's going to slow the amount of air into that Venturi, and gonna need less fuel for that motor. So again, that's just your basic, your carburetor there. Comment me if you have questions, give us a thumbs up if that's been helpful. I hope it has been. I'm gonna continue through this carburetor here. At this time, I'm gonna take our slide out. I'm gonna finish putting our bowl on here. Make sure, inspect this gasket really good. Make sure there's no rips or tears. If you purchase a jet kit, this gasket will most of the time come with that kit. Replace that when you do get a rebuild kit. Set these screws on there, snug these up. Again, if you've got a good gasket, you don't have to go nuts on these screws and really torque them down a bunch. You just want that to seal. Once those are snugged up, we're gonna flip our carburetor over to this side. We've got our air fuel screw, which is here. Now this is determined by how many turns in and out this screw is. So your manual may say, for your air fuel screw, it may say 2.5 turns. So what that means is you're gonna turn this screw all the way in until it's snugged up, and then you're gonna back it out 2.5 turns. That is where this carburetor is set, is 2.5 turns out. And the way that you do that, again, turn it in. So we've got half, 1.5, 2.5. 2.5 turns out is what this carburetor is set out. So we've got half turn, 1.5, 2.5. Now you can go as far as 3 or 4 turns out before this screw is actually loose enough to actually fall out. There's a spring in there, there's a washer, and there's an O-ring that's gonna cause this screw to stay in even though you're turning it out. And typically you would think that would allow that screw to just fall out of there. That's not the case because of the spring, but that is how you determine your air fuel screw. We've got a little different setup for our idle adjust, and the fact that this actually has a 10 millimeter nut on here that's gonna be a lock nut. So when you go to adjust your idle, you're gonna need to loosen up this lock nut here, adjust your idle, and you can just leave this lock nut loosed while you adjust that idle. But when you get that to the correct position there and you feel like your motorcycle is idling properly, take and snug that 10 millimeter screw back up. A lot of times these have the same system as these where you have a spring tension on here. It's not going to loosen or screw in because of that spring. This style happens to have a lock nut on there, and that's what allows this idle adjust to work properly. Better choke assembly here, takes a 14 millimeter wrench, loosen that up. We're gonna be able to unscrew that brass 14 millimeter fitting here. And when we get that unscrewed, we're gonna be able to pull the entire plunger, spring, knob, and cap out in one pull there. And this is your choke assembly here. Again, pull that choke knob up. That's going to choke your motorcycle. Push it down once your motorcycle is completely warmed up. You can, and I would suggest, running carbon choke cleaner through here. Make sure this is all cleaned out. Make sure those orifices are in good condition to make sure there's no debris stuck in there. Going back together then, you'll have to put a little bit of pressure down on this 14 millimeter fitting here because that spring is pushing it up, which is what you want. When you get that to the correct position there, snug it down, and then make sure that your choke is staying up and staying down like it should. We're gonna take and put our slide in and our needle, and we're gonna finish up this carb clean. Slide has got a slot here that's longer and more narrow, and then we've got a more wide, more short indention there. You wanna make sure that you put this in properly. Our choke assembly is actually gonna wear right here on this slide assembly, so when you turn your choke in, it's gonna take and push right here and slide this choke up. Turn it down, it's gonna go the other way. So you wanna make sure that you get this in the correct position. You will not be able to put this in backwards. without going through and damaging some stuff severely. So if you've got to get a hammer and a punch to push this slide in, I would suggest inspecting it to make sure that you're putting it in the correct position there. The other thing to watch is take a couple fingers there, stick it down in this inlet here, because you want to make sure that that needle falls into position there. Otherwise, it's going to hold that slide up. You rebuild your entire carburetor, you put your throttle back on there, you start your motorcycle in a split second that is bouncing off the rev limiter. It's probably because your needle is stuck in the open position like that. So you forced your cap on there, and you've got your carburetor completely back together, and that thing's bouncing off the rev limiter. It's extremely frustrating because you just didn't get that cap in there correctly. So again, your throttle cable is going to come down, slide in your slide. Again, most of the time this is all going to be intact before you even put this back on the motorcycle, but you should have your cable holder in there, should have your spring. I'm going to let that drop, and then you should have your cap, and make sure that that spring falls into its position there. Make sure that that rubber seal is in good condition as well. Spin that on, and that is going to be a complete carb clean on a Kawasaki KX250 motorcycle. If you found this video helpful, make sure you give us a thumbs up. Make sure you like and subscribe. We appreciate all the support we get. And please purchase parts from us if you need for this motorcycle. We'll continue making videos for this motorcycle and many others. Check out our channel for those. Thanks for watching.